Hello guys, I am back with another video, but before starting, let me introduce myself first. I am Lavish Gupta, and in this video, we are going to study bank reconciliation statement. So let's start. So in this video, we are going to study three things, which are: what is bank reconciliation statement, how to prepare it and why we prepare it, and also an example of bank reconciliation statement, so you guys can easily understand it. Okay. So to know about what is bank reconciliation statement, you guys should have some basic knowledge of two things, which are passbook and cash book, which is also known as bank book. Now, as you guys are studying accountancy instead of A, B, C, so let me assume that you guys are grown enough to know what a passbook is. Okay. But still, I know that there may be some people among you guys who doesn't know what a passbook is, because in India, still many families doesn't have a bank account. So, yeah, for those who doesn't know, a passbook is the record of deposit and withdrawal of a person made with the bank. That is, when you deposit money in the bank, it gets credited in your passbook, and when you withdraw money from your bank, it gets debited from your passbook. And this passbook is maintained by the bank. So this is what a passbook is. Now the next thing is bank book, which is also known as cash book, as I previously said, and it is usually the bank column of the cash book. So cash book or bank book is usually studied before studying bank reconciliation statement. Therefore, most of you may already studied it or know about it. For those who don't, a cash book is a book in which receipt and payment of money are recorded. But unlike passbook, which is prepared by bank, cash book is prepared by the customer of the bank. Okay. So, or we can say it is prepared by the business. Now, cash book has two columns, which is cash column and bank column. But in bank reconciliation statement, we are only concerned with bank column, because bank reconciliation is only about those transactions which are related to bank. So from this, we can say that passbook and cash book are the statement of receipt and payment. But the only difference is that passbook is prepared by bank and the cash book or bank book is prepared by the customer of the bank, that is business. Now the thing is that most of the time the balance of passbook and the balance of cash book doesn't match, because of which we prepare bank reconciliation statement. So we can say that bank reconciliation statement is a statement which explains the difference among balances of a passbook and a bank book. Now, as I said, sometimes passbook and cash book doesn't match or do not match, but the question is why? So let's understand. See, as I said, bank book is prepared by bank, which is usually correct, and the cash book is prepared by the customer of the bank or the business, who can or which can commit errors. So sometimes, because of the error committed by the customer or the business in recording the transactions in the bank column of the cash book or in the bank book, there comes a difference among the balances of cash book and passbook. The reason of mismatch is error in recording. Another reason of mismatch is difference in timing. For example, when we deposit a check in the bank, we immediately debit the cash book with the amount of check. But it takes time by the bank to deposit the check in the account. And if we check the balance of passbook and bank book during such period, there will be a mismatch. Yet another reason is no information regarding the transaction. For example, when bank pays interest, it credits the passbook. But we do not know about such interest until we check the passbook. So we do not record it in the bank book or in the bank column of the cash book, which results in mismatch. Now let's study how to prepare bank reconciliation statement, which is also known as BRS, with the problem. So here is our problem, where it is stated: prepare bank reconciliation statement of ABC Limited from the information given below. Let's show you guys how to solve it. So here is the format of bank reconciliation statement, and I want to tell you guys that there is no standard format of BRS. So you guys can prepare it anyway, but this is still the best format according to me. Okay. So we always start with either the balance of cash book or the balance of passbook. It depends upon the problem. As you can see, in this problem, we are given balance as per cash book rupees 25,000. So we will start with this. So balance as per cash book rupees 25,000. Now before going to next step, you guys need to know what is the motive behind preparing bank reconciliation statement. For example, trading account is prepared to know gross profit. That is the end result of trading account is either gross profit or gross loss. Similarly, end result of profit and loss account is either net profit or net loss. So the question is, what is the motive behind preparing BRS? What will be the end result of preparing BRS, or what we are trying to find here? And the answer is, as I previously said, we are going to find the difference between cash book and passbook, and we will reverse them so that if we start with the balance of cash book, or if we start with if we start with balance as per cash book, the end result will be balance as per passbook, and if we start with balance as per passbook, the end result will be balance as per cash book. Now the second step will be to reverse the entries, which results in the difference between balances of passbook and cash book. So let's continue. So our second transaction is withdrawn rupees 2000 from bank but recorded as rupees 2500 in cash book. That means we have recorded 500 extra in cash book, which results in the lower balance of cash book as compared to passbook. Because as per passbook, we have withdrawn only rupees 2000. But as per cash book, we have withdrawn rupees 2500. So we have deducted 500 extra from the cash book. So to reverse the entry, we will add this 500 in the cash book. Therefore, add extra amount deducted from the cash book, rupees 500. I hope you got it. If not, nothing to worry. You can go a little back and watch this step again, or you can continue and under this concept in next entries. Okay. So the third entry is interest given by bank rupees 50 and not recorded in cash book. Okay. So when bank give interest on our money, it results in the increase of balance in the passbook. But the account holder will only come to know of such interest when he sees the passbook. Therefore, the balance of cash book becomes less than the balance of passbook. And so to make the balance equal, we will record the interest given by bank in the cash book. Therefore, add interest given by the bank rupees 50. Now going to fourth entry, it is check received from Mohan deposited into the bank not yet cleared rupees 1000. In this transaction, ABC Limited has received check from Mohan and deposited it into the bank, which is not yet cleared. As you guys may know, that sometimes bank takes time to clear checks because of various reasons. So here when ABC Limited saw the passbook, the check was not cleared, although it was not aware of it, and therefore recorded it in the cash book, which results in the difference between passbook and cash book. Now as the balance of cash book got increased by the amount of check, therefore we will reverse the transaction and will deduct such amount from the cash book, so that balance of both books get equal. So less check received from Mohan not yet cleared, rupees 1000. Now the fifth transaction is check issued to Ram not yet presented for the payment, rupees 1500. In this transaction, ABC Limited has given a check to Ram. Therefore, it will assume that Ram has presented it for payment and the money is deducted from the bank. Therefore, it has already deducted the amount of check from the cash book. But when ABC Limited sees the passbook, it comes to know that the check is still not presented for payment. Therefore, it has to reverse the transaction in the cash book. So, as it has already deducted rupees 1500 from the cash book, now it has to add it back. Therefore, add check issued to Ram not yet presented for payment, rupees 1500. Now, the next entry is deposited rupees 5000 in bank but recorded as rupees 3500 in cash book. So here in this entry, ABC Limited has deposited rupees 5000 in bank, but wrongly recorded it as 3500, which results in the difference between the balances of both books. Therefore, to balance the both books, we have to add rupees 1500 in the cash book. Therefore, add less amount recorded in cash book, rupees 1500. Now the seventh and last transaction is check received entered twice in cash book, rupees 2000. So when we receive check from someone, it increases the balance of both passbook and cash book. But here we have added such amount in the cash book two times. Therefore we have to deduct rupees 2000 from the cash book so as to make the balances of both books equal. Therefore, less check entered twice in cash book rupees 2000. Now what we have to do is to add all these transactions first and then add the amount into the balance as per cash book. Okay. So after adding all this, we get rupees 3550. And which when added to rupees 25,000 will become 28,550. Now we have to subtract the below amount from this 28,550 and we will get rupees 3000, which after subtracting from 28,550 we will get 25,550, which is our balance as per passbook. So we found our balance as per passbook from the balance as per cash book, which is the motive of bank reconciliation statement. So that's all. Hope you guys got it. If not, do tell me what else I should explain here and I will make a new video for that. And please do not forget to like, comment and subscribe, as it will motivate me to make more and more videos for you guys. Thank you.